APIA Vote, thank you for your involvement in all of this and the work that you do each and every day. This is just an incredibly challenging time for our country, and we have to come together. We have to lock arms and come together and stand up for the values that have always made this country great. Values such as the power of immigration and the power of inclusion and the power of treating everybody with dignity and respect.
Thank you to Gary Peters, our great senator from the state of Michigan, and his wonderful staff who have always sought to lift up the voices of those who often can be invisible, including myself, by being present in various community and civic organizations. And that's something that I have sought to do from the time that I moved to Troy, whether it was the PTA or the civic organizations or the city itself as a planning commissioner. And I think that that's something that I want to ask others to do as well, to sort of normalize our selves as members of the community, as volunteering is the ultimate exercise in democracy.
Thank you, Rebecca, APIA Vote Michigan.
I appreciate APIA Vote having this space for us to have these discussions. And thank you to Senator Peters and your team for reaching out to Asian American communities and organizations, because it's so important that we're just now having this conversation. But racism has existed for decades.
Thank you so much, Rebecca, APIA Vote, for organizing this opportunity to meet and speak with Senator Peters. It's a great honor, and so wonderful to have your support and leadership.
And so my question to you, Senator Peter, has to do with our Southeast Asian communities.
Is there anything that you could advise that can be done to proactively, before these incidents, that in the legislature as well as in the community level?
As many of us who do community work, we know that if we're to see real change and effect real change, we must do so in partnership with across the board, with community members, community organizations, and government officials.
Rebecca, again, thank you for hosting this, and thank you for beginning this dialogue. This is not one and done. I look forward to continuing this discussion in the months ahead.